State TV, aka Fox News, has been crushing LTC Vindman. And here's one of the ugliest examples.
Here we have a U.S. national security official who is advising Ukraine while working inside the White House, apparently against the president's interest, and usually they spoke in English. Isn't that kind of an interesting angle on this story?
I find that astounding, and some people might call that espionage, but it doesn't actually seem to add any new facts to what we know.
John Yoo is the man speaking there, former U.S. Deputy Assistant Attorney General. Welcome to Primetime. I respect you taking this invitation.
Chris, thanks for having me on and giving me a chance to, I hope, clarify what I was trying to say, which was I wasn't questioning Lieutenant Colonel Vindman's patriotism. I have a lot of respect for people who wear the uniform, who are decorated for service in Afghanistan, Iraq. When Laura was reading me the facts of the case, what I was focusing on was that it seemed to me the Ukrainians were engaging in espionage. And I really regret the choice of words, but I was thinking about Ukrainians engaging
right.
in espionage.
I hear
not
you,
Lieutenant
John. And
Colonel
look,
Vindman.
Look, if you say you're sorry, that's good enough for me on this show. But I just want to go through it because you're a smart mm-hmm. guy. I've done my homework on you. Laura Ingraham was trying to assassinate the character of Vindman. That's what she does. She's a proxy for our president. She's a brilliant legal mind. She's a talented communicator. And she is trying to protect this president. How could you have thought she was talking about Ukraine when she was obviously talking about Vindman and these ugly suggestions that he was working in both sides? You know for a fact they came to him for help with Giuliani. He was doing his job. How could you let her get away with that?
I really do think that the Ukrainians are the ones engaged in espionage. And I
how is that
when I
espionage?
Went back and looked at the
oh, you
the
thought
government
that's what she was referring to.
No,
go ahead, explain.
No, I was listening to her description of the story, and what I focused on was a foreign government trying to call an official in our National Security Council and get advice on how to deal with Rudy Giuliani, who I agree with you from the last clip has just gone completely off the reservation. And I think that's, to me, an effort to make a contact and engage in espionage, but not on Lieutenant Colonel Vindman's part. I really actually don't have any doubts that he did the right thing in reporting his concerns up the chain of command. And I just want to make clear, I'm not questioning his patriotism in any way. I actually
well, what do you think about Laura Ingraham
doing
exactly that? I know you like going on Fox News. I know you defend the president from time to time. I have no problem with that. You're welcome on this show to do the same thing. But you're going to go on a show and listen to somebody try to impugn the character of a man you're now calling a patriot? What do you think of what you tried to do?
What I was saying, and this is after, I think after the clip you showed, was I wanted to say, which I think I did, was that actually Lieutenant Colonel Vindman's presence or point was not actually materially important to the story because he was confirming the facts of what we already knew, which was that President Trump had made a call with the president and had seemed to ask for a quid pro quo between releasing Ukrainian aid and conducting some investigation into Hunter Biden and his service on natural gas companies.
Right. You don't have any question about what actually happened here, do you? I mean, do you need any more proof with somebody with your pedigree that the president clearly wanted an investigation of the Bidens and clearly they were holding up aid in a meeting until he got a public recognition that that would happen?
No, actually, I don't have any doubts about that because you can read them in the transcript of the phone call that the White House released on. So that was my point, was that Lieutenant Colonel Vindman shouldn't be the key question or key character in all this because he's just confirming the facts that were already laid out in the previous testimony and in the telephone call.
Now, 2 points. One is, why wouldn't Ukraine, when confronted with this bizarre situation where a guy who has no business and no role in U.S. diplomacy is hammering them for very specific things that are very curious, reaches out to someone they know who's in charge of the relationship to say, what do we do? You really think that's espionage?
I think on the foreign government's part it is. You know, usually you would talk to the State Department, diplomats on the scene. You know, the National Security Council is a very sensitive body.
They did, though. They talked to Volcker. They talked to everybody they could because this was crazy time, what was going on.
No, and I don't blame the Ukrainians for trying to do what they did. But
you just said it was espionage.
To try to call an intelligence official in the National Security Council on their part sounds to me like espionage. I think the Russians and Ukrainians have been up to all kinds of things throughout this entire investigation to our national detriment. I think we're being played sometimes for fools by them. And I have no doubt that what they're up to is espionage.
Do you think that could be a component of what's going on with Mr. Rudy Giuliani, that all of a sudden he winds up working with two people to advance the president's interests who are now indicted and have all these connections to Russian funny money, and we're getting wires of money that oddly resemble the amounts that they gave him? Do you think that's part of the component there?
Oh, yes. I think actually part of what's going on is that people in our government, or actually in the circle of private people around the president, are getting played by the intelligence services of other countries. I think that's an inescapable conclusion.
Well, I see that with Russia, but I don't see how Ukraine was playing the president. What happened with Ukraine was the president putting an agenda on them. I mean, is there any other way to see it?
Well, of course, you know, what the phone transcript shows is that the president wanted them to conduct an investigation. He wanted them to do a favor. And then we're seeing these contacts, these communications, where the president and Rudy Giuliani and Ambassador Sondland are trying to pressure them into doing that investigation as the cost or price of a meeting, and then later foreign aid. Chris, I don't disagree with you. I think the hard question on impeachment now is not the facts of what happened. I think those have been proven out. It's whether this is a high crime and misdemeanor, or whether this should be decided in the Senate in a trial, or whether this should be decided at the ballot box in November.
I think it's a legitimate argument. I think that you can hear good faith arguments about why this isn't worthy of removal. I think we're a little bit far away from that. But the idea of triggering the mechanism, you know, abuse of power like this, you know, this is not only what the founding fathers were worried about. We just came out of the Mueller probe, John, where the only thing both sides agreed on was that you're not supposed to mess with foreign powers. The president did this literally on the same day Mueller was saying, Mr. Trump's not out of the woods. I mean, how do you take that as a signal of anything other than this president is worthy, is willing to abuse his power no matter what?
Chris, you've had me on your show before. I've been happy to say that. I agree with you on the fact that the framers were worried and did draft the impeachment clause about to get at presidents who put their personal interests above the national interest when it came to foreign policy. The other thing, though, they're worried about is impeachment being used as a tool by Congress to 100%. Control presidents.
100%. Federalist Paper number 65. Alexander Hamilton says this cannot be just about numbers, that if you have more, you get to get rid of the person, that this process will awaken all of the ugliest partisan impulses, and it has to be better than that. No question. And I think we have to go through this. But here's my thing for you, John. Do you regret not saying to the host of that show, hey, don't talk about Vindman like that. We don't know that he's a never-Trumper. No, don't accuse him of being a spy. This is ugly stuff. This is beneath us as Americans. We don't make that kind of xenophobic and jingoistic arguments about our own.
Well, what I wish I had said, and I just didn't have time to, is that I didn't know the facts. I didn't know about Lieutenant Colonel Vindman, and I wish I had said, let's find out more and let's hear the facts first before we rush to any judgments. And I didn't mean to rush to any judgments. Chris, I really appreciate what you're saying, and I do share your views on this. I think I made a mistake in not being clear in what I thought.
I'm happy to give you the opportunity to clarify it. I'm not into the gotcha contest. That's the other place where you hang out. That's what they're trying to do, and I understand why. We both know they can't deal with the facts in this situation. One last quick question. Rudy Giuliani's investigations, criminal and national security, it's an intelligence investigation. Do you think that there is legitimate concern on what you know so far in terms of there being teeth to looking at him?
Well, if you look at the facts that are coming out or just the suggestions that are coming out in the newspapers, I can see why his old office, the Southern District of New York, and the U.S. Attorney's Office is open an investigation. It does seem he was associating with, again, these Ukrainians who might have been receiving money from sources abroad and trying to funnel the money into the president's campaign. That doesn't mean Rudy Giuliani is guilty of anything,
No. But
I can completely see why he's under investigation because
Yes. Of
his relation with these people who definitely have violated federal law.
And I believe that for us, in terms of the political analysis, you can't say that the president didn't know what he was doing and that he didn't really mean it that way, because Rudy Giuliani answers all that curiosity. He was doing a shadow parallel operation to get done what the president wanted to get done. John Yoo, you're always welcome on this show. I did not want you stained
Thanks,
with
Chris.
The kind of BS that's going on over there. I know why they're doing it. I wanted to give you a chance not to be a part of it. Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you.